Hi everyone, so this is a new approach. We're gonna do a bit of reactions and we're gonna take you through some of the things we've seen and done at recent events. The most recent event I've been to was the EICMA show, the World Motorcycle Show. Most of the big brands of the world were there. There was so much to see, so let's get into it. These large exhibition halls, there's 22 exhibition halls, they take up about five or six of them. So as soon as you get into the show, you start to see, you know, a few interesting brands. You've got here, you've got BMW with one of their e-scooters. You've got Ducati with their electric bikes on display. Horwin, which is an interesting brand, where they had these electric high-powered scooters on display that can go up to 100 miles an hour. And yeah, they're super comfortable, super modern looking. So this was the most interesting thing I think I saw at the whole show. It's a concept vehicle, but it doesn't have normal steering. It has weight balance steering. So inside the body of the bike, there's a weight which shifts, and this allows the motorcycle to steer. As you can see, it's got some pretty funky design. So if you get up close to it, you can see it's got a lot of interesting design features. It's got more of a recumbent position for the rider. It's got massive disc brakes. It's got suspension sort of integrated, should we say. But it steers and it leans like this because there's a weight inside which is displaced. Here we've moved on to the Zero stand, and Zero motorcycles, as you know, all electric, and they had really a lot of impressive offerings there. They had everything up close to see, touring bike, and yeah, you know, Zero Motorcycle, actually, when you look at them and what they've produced and put everything together, it really is impressive. And obviously they had on display some electric motorbikes with police livery or service livery. So it was a very impressive stand to see. Now this is an important bit here. Now I didn't actually get much shots of the Energica stand, but I just wanted to show you. So there's Ducati stand and Energica's right next to it. They were the bike supplier for the MotoGP E up until now. So they've got high performance electric street bikes, touring bikes. They've got four main products. If I was somebody at Ducati, I would definitely be feeling the pressure to produce an electric product based on just the competition I've got around me. So this is the Cake Buck, which as you know, Cake, we've covered that on our channel before. It's got a lot of design look and feel to it, but it's basically an electric motocross about raw power. And it's got a large battery, which they say lasts up to about 3 hours of riding. It's a quality bike. Don't forget to check out a link in the description for where we covered this previously. Now I want to get into Yadea, which is an interesting Chinese brand. They said to me, 15 million units a year, or 16 million units a year. A million in Europe, 15 million in China. That's a lot of electric two-wheeled vehicles. These are electric equivalent of 125. 250cc motorbikes. You've got a lot of attention. This is the kind of company to watch, with global operations, fully invested in the electric system. And they had their e-bikes for city use here. They've got a couple of some cruiser styles. They've got some foldables. Now here we've got Moto Parilla, which is an interesting Italian e-bike brand. So they're focused mainly on electric mountain bikes. And here they've got their sort of concept bike. And they've gone for some very bold, almost crazy designs. And but the geometry, believe it or not, is pretty modern and up to date. And obviously the componentry is up there with the most modern electric mountain bikes. So we're gonna hopefully get one of these to test at some point soon. But they're really interesting. They come with Pollini motors and 800 watt hour batteries. So these things are certainly distinctive. Now, as you wander around the show, you often find lots of these sort of unknown branded electric motorbikes, or from brands you've never heard of from Asia. And these are a few that I found just sitting there by the wayside. And now I couldn't really find the brand name for half of these bikes, but they're all made in Turkey. And the reason they're made in Turkey is because that way they can circumnavigate the anti-dumping laws. So they're actually made in Turkey and put together in Turkey, I think with product and materials from China. So that way they have Turkey has an agreement with the European Union, so they can import low value or competitive value products into the European Union market as they're produced close to home. Got a rare shot of me with the new. Now, what was interesting about this city bike was the fact that it's got two batteries in it, two 500 watt hour batteries, so you've got 1,000 watts. So with an e-bike like this, getting around the city and worrying about range, you're not gonna have to worry. With 1,000 watts, you can probably go, I'd say 60 or even 100 miles possibly, especially if it's flat. Here's another motor of interest. You often wouldn't pick this up straight away, but it was Horwin. Again, on a random stand, I found this CR6. Paulini, who had their motors on display, these were their MX e-bike motors, so meant for mountain bikes, and this was their 800 watt hour battery, or 880 watt hour battery. It was an incredibly interesting product to have, and they're competitive. These products are super serviceable. So let's go back to the Ducati stand. Here we go. We have their electric road bike here on display called the Forta, and this will be available globally as they enter into the market. It's very well made, very nice finishing on it. It's got a hub motor in the rear wheel. So it was interesting to see Benelli. So they are a famous Italian motorbike brand. In fact, I even know one of the old family owners. They live not far from me. But basically, this company is now Chinese owned, and they have a huge quantity of electric bikes, and it took up at least a third of their stand. So, and this is up close what they are, and they've got massive batteries. They've just basically not worried too much about the styling, in my opinion, but they've really gone for range. Here's like a 900 watt hour battery, a 1,000 watt hour battery. They've really focused on range and performance. One of the things I forgot to mention about Yadea is they're very interested in battery swapping programs, so you don't have to worry about charging your battery. You can just switch it out and shove it in, especially for delivery. And that was one of the things they had there. They had these really cool delivery-based electric bikes on display. This is an electric scooter, so the idea is you can go around the city delivering stuff, and also this can work in an adventure mode. So it's for sure an important part of the future, and this was their take on it. And I have to say, for some of the brands and the styling cues that I've seen, these were very good looking bikes. Now we're getting to the last part of what I saw at the show. Now, interesting, I saw the Instense Tazer, and they're sold across Europe through parts of Europe and in America through Instense. A lot of people can come to e-mountain bikes from the motorbike world on their bike, what I would call a very motocross orientated setup. Definitely not designed to appeal to the cyclist. It's more designed to appeal to the motorcyclist. Now, Bafang are quite interesting because they always have their different products on display at different shows I've been to. Here they have their lightweight e-bike motor on display and battery. So this is their answer to the showing, let's say, of all the other companies which are producing lightweight motors, giving the bikes a look that's more similar to a normal mountain bike. Okay, so the last company I wanted to cover here was Oli. Now, this is super interesting for me to try. I've tried their motors in the past. Really an unknown company, but they make a really good quality motor. This has got a 900 watt hour battery in it and a motor. It's got quite a long down tube to it, but I really want to try one of these, and I should have one of these to test soon. And yes, certainly it's run by Olympia. They're an old brand, so they're from 1882, but they're making some very interesting electric mountain bikes here with 900 watt hour batteries, and they've got this new range of carbon high-end bikes. Okay guys, so that's it. I hope you enjoyed that brief look there around at EICMA. It was an interesting range of products on display. The biggest thing I noticed on the electric pedal bike market, especially mountain bikes and urban bikes, was the idea of range. All the bike companies were trying to put as big a batteries as they could in there, or at the other end of the scale, there were the lightest weight bikes possible with small batteries and small motors that just give you a gentle assist. Don't forget to like and subscribe and leave a comment below. And thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next video.